Welcome to Strength of Materials. We are in the module number 2, Compound Stresses or Complex Stresses. So we have seen related to simple shear and simple stress and simple shear stress, which is in the previous topic which we have dealt, wherein the pure normal or direct stresses or pure shear stresses are occurred. However, both direct and shear stresses across any section are brought into play, and the resultant stress will be either normal or tangential. So when both shear stress and normal stress are coming into the play, that time the resultant stress is acting in some direction. So that will be coming into account. So either the resultant stress will be either normal or tangential to the plane. So we can say that they can be either acting perpendicular to the plane or they can be acting tangential to the plane. So resultant stress, when it is acting, either it may be acting in the tangential or it may be acting directly perpendicular to the plane. Sometimes what happens in the practice, if we take these parts or applied loads may be greater than the resultant stress which is acting. So if we take two forces, so in these two forces, the resultant force is acting in this direction. So this resultant stress may be less and the other applied loads may be greater, either in this direction or in this direction. So that way the direction of resultant is going to move. If this is more, it will be acting in this direction. If this is more, it will be acting in y direction. So we can say this is x direction, this is y direction, and resultant is going to act in y and x in between the directions. So also we can say that if the force is acting in downward direction and this force is acting in downward direction, resultant is acting in this direction. So if one force is acting in outward and one force is acting in inward, so maybe the resultant is acting in this way or the resultant is acting in this way. In that time, whatever the force resultant is going to come, that way the force resultants are going to act. The system in which direct stress and shear stresses act simultaneously is called as the complex, compound, or combined stresses. So we can say that is complex name or compound name or combined, both are, all three are same. So this type of the topic is what is the complex stresses and compound stresses. So in this part, we can see the introduction is, in general, if a plane element is removed from a strained material, so if we are taking a big body of the body, we are taking a small element outside. So small element when we take outside and which is subjected to direct stress along the x-axis and y-axis, namely sigma x, sigma y, together with the shear stress along the sides, namely as tau xy, as shown in this particular figure, we can see. So here we can say that the particular figure is in this way. So this is x direction, this is y direction, wherein the particular sigma y is acting, which is perpendicular, sigma x is acting, which is also perpendicular and parallel to x direction. So sigma y is perpendicular to x direction, sigma x is perpendicular to y direction, and the particular part which we can say, that is the tau xy, the shear stresses which are acting on the body, tau xy are the shear stresses which are acting on the body. So this is the one kind of two-dimensional stress system or a biaxial type of stress system which is acting on the body. Complex stress or a compound stresses. So in this part, again the part is, if the figure represents general case of a two-dimensional stress or a biaxial stress system. So we need to understand that what is biaxial and what is two-dimensional and what is single-dimensional. Single-dimensional is what we are taking, force is acting, stress is calculated. The force may be acting in normal direction, the force may be acting in shear stress direction, tangential to the particular body. But in this part of complex stress or compound stresses, we need to think the forces are acting combined. Combined means the biaxial force is also acting, we can call biaxial forces. So that is how normal force is also acting and as well as shear force is also acting. We need to come and we need to have this part into our mind that the particular forces are acting. So for normal stresses, tensile is considered as positive. So we can see whichever we will take, that is as a positive. So sigma x if we consider as a positive and sigma y opposite direction and vice versa. Shear stress producing clockwise couple. So this particular sigma x which is producing a clockwise couple. So we can say this particular shear stress and this particular shear stress are providing a clockwise rotation. So that clockwise rotation we will take it as a positive moment. And the upper left arm which is coming in this way tau xy and this way tau xy, they both will rotate in the anti-clockwise direction. We take it as a negative sign of moment which is acting. So that way we can say, so here it is sigma x and sigma y, if it both are positive, sigma y will be negative. If this is x direction, this is y direction, both are positive and they will be acting in the vice versa, that is this will be negative and this will be negative. So that type of complex forces are acting. So when we are taking this complex forces or compound stresses, we need to have the clear sign convention. For the instant part, I'll be only dealing for the first particular part. So understand this part of figure and understand the forces, how they are acting, because we are going to say with the particular forces only what will be the stress determinations, that is what will be the value of sigma y, what is the value of sigma tau, tau xy, what is the value of sigma x, that way. So this particular figure is the most important part in the complex stresses, because the numericals will be also dealt with this particular type of sigma x, sigma y, that type of forces are acting on a particular body, which will be always two or dimensional system or biaxial dimension system stresses are going to act. Thank you and see you in the next video.